What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. If you're tuning in for the first time, I have to say welcome to my channel. Friends, it's Michelle right here. I'm so excited to finally be sitting down and recording another video for you guys. So, this video is a story time, a lot of information going on this video. I'm going to be answering some of your questions. I'm going to give you my story on how I became a first-time home buyer, how I have my very first home, and how I am super excited to be able to sit right here on this space in my bedroom and say that I think that this will be my permanent space for a while. That's my little one. So I kind of arranged it a little bit as right now. I'm going to get more furniture, different furniture, but this is what I have right now, and I really needed to make this video for you guys. So today's video, guys, coming at you, is going to be a story time on how I became a first-time home buyer, how I'm a homeowner, my process, your questions answered, and just kind of fill you in into my life and my little one right over there. I don't think he'll let me record, but fingers crossed. So let's go ahead and jump into this video, guys. All right, guys, so if you haven't subscribed yet to my channel, make sure you hit subscribe right down there. Make sure you turn on your notification bell and make sure you follow me on Instagram, Frances2S.Michelle, because I have a lot of things going on and I can't wait to share with you guys, and I don't want you guys to miss anything. So guys, this video is gonna be, like I said, a story time, so let's just get right to it. A lot of you guys messaged me on Instagram and said to me, please talk about the process. We are in the process of buying a house. We wanna buy a house. We don't know how to start. We don't know the process. We're scared. Share with us what you went through and all that. So that is what I'm gonna be doing here today, guys. So if you're thinking of buying a house and you're buying a house or you're thinking to buy a house pretty soon or far out, I kind of wanna give you guys my story and kind of everything that I went through, and just hopefully one inspires you, two kind of gives you information, and three, maybe you can clear out some doubts or questions you guys may have. Buying a house, it is not an easy process. I tell you that buying a house is very, very stressful, very hard, but at the end, it is so worth everything you went through. So we always had in the back of our head, we've rented for 10 years, and we've always had in the back of our head to purchase a house. We were like, let's buy a house, let's buy a house. We have kids. We had one, then we had another one, and then we had our third child, and we're like, you know, it sucks to live in an apartment. They can't run, they can't be kids, you can't have a yard, you can't give them outside. So it was really hard. If you're a family and you have kids, it's really hard to kind of live in an apartment. So we were like, every year that would come around, like, this is the year we buy a house, or let's fix our credit and let's get a house next year. So the beginning of this year, we were like, let's have this year to be the one to fix the credit and buy a house for the beginning of 2020. So we kind of like came across our church, a realtor, and we were like, oh yeah, we want to buy a house, but we know that our credit is not yet there yet. What can we do? The guy was like, let's do it. Let's look at the credit. Let's start looking at houses. Let's just start the process. And we're like, all right, fine, let's do it. We were like, okay. So July comes around and he starts showing us houses, like, hey, you guys want to come out, look at houses? And we were like, no, that's okay. You know, we know that we're far from there. Our credit is not where it needs to be. Mind you, we're in the state of Florida. I'm talking about the state of Florida. I'm not sure if everyone in the United States, but don't quote me on it. But I know that in the state of Florida, a minimum credit to start purchasing a house is 580. And where they really want you to be at, the banks are 620 or above. So our credit was not at 680, to be honest. We were very, very reckless. We were very, very immature when we started our credit. We did not know that credit is such an important factor, is such an important thing in every human being's life. And we were young. Like I said, I married when I was 21. I got my first credit card when I was 18. It was a $300 credit card. I went at it and I just like I remember I bought myself a sidekick, a phone sidekick, and then I bought my mom a phone, and I didn't even remember paying it. So I didn't have parents to tell me, hey, credit is really, really important. Please make sure you take care of it. I didn't have anyone tell me that. So coming into marriage, my husband neither, so we kind of just took credit, our credit for granted, and we did a lot of dumb stuff. So we go a Saturday to see a house, and we love the house, and of course I'm a woman, and I'm like, oh my god, the kitchen, blah, blah. The girl kind of like pushed us, not a realtor, the girl from the sales from our the house kind of pushed us to be like, hey, just put an application and see where you guys at. And I was like, okay, let's do it, let's just put an application just to see where we at. We put an application that day for the house, of course. Comes back denied because our credit wasn't at 580. It was like few points. The girl was like, oh, you have to pay this, 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 this. There are a lot of things on our credit that we needed to pay. It came out to like $12,000 with everything in the credit. And she was like, if you pay that within a month or so, your credit score will improve dramatically and you'll be able to get a house. I was like, what? You're telling me to come up with almost 12 grand in 30 days? Plus, I have to save deposit. Plus, I have to save saving costs. Like, what? These people that work for the bank and work for houses live like in a bubble where they're just like, oh, it's easy for everyone to come up with 40,000, 50,000 off the bat. So we were like a little disappointed, but we were just like, whatever about it. I told you we were not going to get a house this year. So 2 weeks rolled in, and we did end up paying one of the bills that needed to be paid. So we paid it off in full. We're like, all right, let's just get it out of the way. It probably helped us with the credit score. So 2 weeks in, the guy, realtor says, hey, I have a few houses lined up for you guys. I need you guys to come see. That is the video of house hunting. I'm going to link it down below. I'm going to put a little thumbnail. If you haven't seen this video, that is when this video came to life. That is when we were starting hunting for a house. We're like, all right, let's do it. I'm just gonna make a series out of it. It'll probably be a 6 month to a year period whether we buy a house, so let's just go ahead and do it. So we went and we saw houses. We fell in love with one specific house, and that is this house that is in that video, guys. So we saw the house, it was a Saturday. We went home and we're like, oh my god, the houses were so beautiful. Oh my god, babe, did you see the one with the big kitchen and the island? It fits 8 chairs. We love hosting. This would be amazing. And we're like, oh yeah, it's pretty. My husband's like, let's go apply. I'm like, babe, we just got denied 2 weeks ago. What makes you think we're gonna apply here and it's gonna get us approved? He's like, let's just go do it. Let's just go do it. So Sunday comes, we go to church, we tell our realtor, hey, we're gonna go apply. And he's like, all right, let's do it. So we get to this place, we sit down with the sales girl, and we apply, and the bank from the developer called us like 10 minutes in, and she was like, listen, it's not a no, but it's definitely a work progress, your credit needs to be worked in. So we were like, all right, fine, what we need to do. And she started naming all the collections that we had. And she was like, if you pay this, you pay that, blah, blah. We're like, oh my God, like, okay, whatever. The sales lady from the developer was like, you know what? I have a guy. Let's call the guy and he is going to make it happen. And I was like, come on. She called the guy. She put in the application with the guy. The guy said, yeah, definitely, I can make this happen. They're just a few points away. There's things in their credit that I can definitely fix, and we can get them into a house within 30 to 45 days. I was like, 30 to 45 days? Like, are you kidding me? This takes anyone 6 months to a year, and you're telling me that you can put me in a house from 30 to 45 days? I was like, that's impossible. She's like, well, the house you like is an inventory house. So the house is ready. It's built already. You don't have to wait 6-8 months to build your home. You can just close in 30 to 45 days and you can live in your house. I was like, that's impossible. Impossible. No one comes up with a 3.5 FHA. It's a FHA loan, which is a first time home buyer. So in here in the state of Florida, again, I'm not sure anywhere else, it's 3.5 of the whole entire amount of the house. So I was like, that's insane, plus closing costs. And she was like, no, the developer covers the costs. There's approximately $18,000 to $20,000 the developer will put in just to close on your home. I was like, huh? So you're telling me I only have to come up with a deposit? She's like, you only have to come up with the 3.5 deposit of your house. I was like, down payment, I'm sorry. I was like, okay. So she was like, all right, that's it. You have this amount of money to put down on the house just to separate the house until the process is finished. And I was like, my husband's like, yeah, I have it. Boop. He did a check, and she grabs a little sticker and she puts it on the lot, and she was like, lot number something is sold. And I was like, well, we haven't had a, we don't have a, sorry, I was looking at my son. We don't have an approval. And the girl's like, if my guy from this bank said he can do it, he can get you in. And I was like, but you're telling me that I need to have amount of money from 30 to 45 days. I don't have any, I don't have that amount of money saved up yet. You know, we're in the process of saving up the money and we have it. You know, we would eventually have it from 6 to 8 months. She was like, no, we're going to do this. And I was like, what? So that was Sunday. That Wednesday, we go into the office of the guy of the loan. And he's like, all right, this is what we're going to work in. You're going to pay, you're going to pay your credit card, pay this credit card, leave it at a $10 balance, leave it at the $10 balance. Let's do this, let's do that. I'm going to call, blah, blah, blah. I was just like, this is happening too fast. And he was like, when can you come up with the money? And we were like looking at everything and we're like, well, how much is it? And they told us the amount of money. And I was like, that's crazy. My husband's like, nah, babe, we can do this. Let's pray on this. Let's do it. Let's pray and let's ask God to open doors. If it's from God, it would happen. And guys, I tell you, doors kept opening. And I was like, this is really happening. So we were like, me and my husband sat down. We're like, we have to come up with this amount of money. So we're going to have to leave the apartment. We paid. This is very personal information, but we're just going to put it out there because I want to be really blunt with you guys. We paid over $2,000 of rent in our apartment. I know it's insane. Florida rent is crazy, guys. So yes, don't come at me. We just wanted to have a nice place to live where my kids were safe and the school was good. So we did end up paying $2,000 of rent a month in our apartment. So we're like, that's money that we can put towards the down payment of the house. So we were like, okay, let's do it. So September 15, we decided that it was time for us to leave the apartment. So we ended up leaving the apartment and we packed up everything. We put it in a storage and we packed up our bags. And the only place we had to go for this process of time was actually Gainesville, where my brother-in-law used to live. He had just recently got an apartment, and it was a two-bedroom apartment, and he lives by himself, so he was like, hey, I have an extra room for you if you guys want to come. And I was like, oh my god, Gainesville, that's like 2 hours away from where we at. I would have to pull out my kids from school, and I was just like, well, this is not gonna work. And then I was like, what are we gonna do? The people from school told us, we'll just take it out of the Osceola, just take them out of the district they're in and put them in Gainesville, and then take them out of Gainesville and put them where they need to be. I was like, that's crazy. I'm not gonna do that to my kids. So we ended up trying homeschooling. So I was like, I'll just homeschool them for the month that we have to be, because our closing date, they scheduled it for October 18th. They scheduled for October 15th. So I was like, that is a month. So long story short, for that 2 weeks we were there, like, we were trying to make it work. Homeschooling was not working. We had to come down to Orlando a couple of times for church and stuff. We needed to do at church. We had things we needed to do down here. So we would travel from Gainesville to Orlando. That's a 2-hour drive pretty much every weekend. It was a lot of money on gas and my kids were tired. So we were like, listen, my kids need to be in a school. So I'm going to take a leap of faith and I'm going to enroll them in their school zone. And I'm going to just stay at my mom's and I'll travel every morning to school and pick them up and all that. Mind you, my mom lives in a studio apartment where it's just her bed and, of course, just the sofa and the kitchen. And not all 5 of us will fit there, so we had to split. I had to stay with my mom and my 3 kids, and my husband had to go stay with his mom. So we did that for about a week and a half, waking up every morning very early to take my kids to school. It was like 30 minute drive to and like a 45 minute drive back to my mom's house. It was very intense living out of a suitcase. Everything was in a suitcase. Everything was packed in our cars. My kids were sleeping in air mattresses. My baby was very, very uncomfortable. My mom's house is controlled. The AC is controlled by the house she lives in, because she rents a little studio. So the house controls the AC, and they wouldn't lower down the AC. And it was hot. It was really, really hot in her house. My kids would have to sleep in underwears. My baby would have to sleep in diapers because it was really hot. And 6 people in that little place. It was really, really, really rough. Really rough, guys. Really rough. I remember that one Saturday, we just got dressed because we want to stay in the little place, and we went and we drove to a shopping center in Orlando, and we bought food for the kids, and we just sat in our car for 2 hours, not having a place to go, not knowing what to do, because it's not like we could go places to spend money, because we really needed to save every dime was coming in. So we sat there for like 2 hours, just like, this is crazy. You know, my kids are tired, we're not sleeping right. They're sleeping with heat. This is just insane. Let's just call it quits. We cannot do this. We've been doing this for almost two and a half weeks, almost going into 3 weeks, and we still have like at least 2 more weeks of going. I don't think I can do this. So I broke down. I told my husband, I can't. This is ridiculous. Let's just take the money we have saved and let's just go find a place and rent. And let's do this like normal people do it, within 6, 8 months, a year of buying a house. And my husband was like, all right, let's do it. We're driving down to the house, where the house is, to tell the girl, you know, we're going to cancel everything. Let's just cancel it. We call a realtor. And we tell our realtor what's going on. We're like, listen, this is really hard. We're going to give up. Da, da, da. And he was like, no, don't do that. Where are you going? He said, we're actually going down to the house just to tell the lady, the sales center, hey, cancel everything. He's like, you know what? I am actually here on an open house. Come down. Let's talk. We get down there. He was like, that's it. I figure out where you guys are going to stay. And we're like, what? He's like, you know, stay at my house. He goes to church, but we don't know him like that. Him and his wife, they do go to church with us, and they're just the sweetest couple, but we didn't know them for them to open up the doors of their house to be like, hey, come in and stay at my house. I was like, this is insane. When we get to their house, the house, it was an hour, 50 minutes away from the kids' school. So I was like, damn, that's like crazy. But they wouldn't have to suffer heat, and they would be a little bit more comfortable. We could all stay in one house. So we went and we stayed, and they not only gave us one room, they gave us 2 freaking rooms. I was like, this is insane. Who does this? So another thing we said, okay, God's definitely working this. So that night, like 2 nights after, we received an email saying that our loan process moved from step 2 to step 3, where they're gathering the paperwork, where they're just, an underwriter is going through it. So we're like, oh my God, this is really happening. This is insane. To this, I'm still doubting everything. I'm still like, oh my God, this is crazy. But it is really happening. So we kept pushing through. We stayed at hotels because sometimes we just wanted to be more comfortable. We wanted to be colder. We just wanted all to be together. And it was a really tough time, guys. A lot of other things happened that God showed us he was actually in control of the situation. So fast forward to closing day. We get to our closing day. We're super excited. We're about to close on our house. It's actually happening. All this is happening. We're like, this is happening. 45 days, we're closing in our house. That's crazy. We did it. I get to the lot, to the signing place, to the title place. And she's like, all right, I'm just going to need your IDs and let's go ahead and start the signing process. It was at 10 o'clock in the morning that day. That night, I didn't sleep. I didn't sleep anything. I was so excited that I was actually going, that this was actually happening. Like, this is happening. We get to that place and I give the lady my, I give the lady my ID. And she's like, oh, honey, your ID expired last month. I was like, what? I can't do it. I can't take it because your ID is fired. I was like, no, this cannot be happening. I have to drive to Kissimmee where my county is from, my ID. And wait, what? Like, we're an hour away from Kissimmee. And then I had to wait like 2-3 hours. I was like, this is not happening. I found a place that was 30 minutes away from the closing that would take my license, although I'm not from that county. So I just drove up and I went with my kids and I was like, let's go, let's do this. I waited 3 hours to redo my license. From there, we drive back down. From the closing being at 10 o'clock in the morning, I ended up getting our keys that day. I ended up getting our keys that day at like 4:45, almost 5 o'clock. But we got the keys and it felt amazing to finally still look at my kids and say, it's over, guys. It's over. We don't have to sleep in your mattresses no more. We don't have to rent anymore. You guys have a home. It's over. We have our home. We have something that belongs to us. No more sleeping hot. No more jumping from hotels to people's houses to where we're gonna stay tonight. Not living out of the suitcase. It's over, you guys. We finally have this blessing. This is amazing. We just drove and we just wanted to get home. And honestly, it's one of the best feelings that I could ever experience. Aside from being a mother, of course, that doesn't top anything. But just to know that you're giving a secure roof to your kids is just amazing, guys. It's amazing. We've gone through hell. We've gone through knowing what it is to literally be homeless. We lost it everything 4 years ago. Lost everything. Lost apartment. We got our cars towed, repoed. We lost everything, and we went to live with friends for over 2 months until we got back on our feet. And we know what it is to lose everything, and we know what it is to pretty much have something. So I tell you this, guys, because a lot of people can be mean and say that, oh, things are easy for you. No, guys, things have never, ever been easy for my family. My husband has had to bust his butt working really hard to provide for his family. I've had to work really hard to keep my family afloat with everything going on in the house. It's been really hard. We prayed so much. Every night we would go to bed praying, God, if this is yours, open a door, and he would open another door. And it just happened, guys. It just happened. It wasn't hard. The banks asked for statements back and forth. You can use your, we had credit cards and we couldn't use them. And we're like, oh my God, how are we gonna leave? Like, how, these, the kids are hungry. Like, we have to do something. We have to do some grocery shopping so I can cook. Guys, it was really, really hard. The process is not easy. The way we went into the process was just jumping of leap of faith after leap of faith, and it was really hard when you have kids. But I feel like if it's from God and you put God before your plans, he would literally do the, he would show you that in the impossible is where he moves. For everybody, it was like, it's impossible for you guys to come up with 3.5 deposit of the down payment in 45 days. It's impossible for you to do this. It's impossible, blah, blah, your credit's not there. He got us our credit way over what it would need it to be. We closed on the house, we gave the money, we came into our house, and we did it, guys. And it was just the most hardest process that I've gone through, but it was, the outcome was amazing. And today I can say that I'm excited to own a house, and I am excited because I feel like a grown-up. Most people get married, they finish school, they get married, they buy a house, they have kids. I didn't finish school, I got pregnant, I got married, I bought a house. It doesn't matter the way you do it, as long as you get your dreams done, as long as you get your goals done, as long as you do it, as long as you put your mind to it and you do it, just do it. Don't tell people to tell you there's a right or wrong way to do it. Just do it. The way you know how to, the way you can, just do it. Whatever it is, just get it done. And guys, I do have to say, with bigger the blessing, bigger the sacrifice. It was tough. It was really tough, but now we have our house, and that's exciting, guys. When it comes to buying a house, I feel like you have to have a plan. Plan it out, especially if you have kids. Do I want to do this 30 days? Do I want to do 40 days? Do I want to do it in a 6-month period? Do I want to do it in an 8-month period? Do I want to do it in a year? Plan it out. Save a lot of money. Save everything you can save, guys, because you are going to need a lot of money. Banks are always asking for bank accounts. Make sure your bank account is right. Make sure you don't have any negative balances. Make sure you don't get hit with fees. Again, the bank is loaning you a ton of money. They want to make sure that they can trust you with that much money. Although, you know, things can happen, but whatever. Make sure your bank account is right. Make sure you find someone that's going to help you work with your credit. I repeat, I am not a believer of this, I'll fix your credit companies. I'm not. We went through them a couple of times and it didn't work out for us. My husband fixed his credit all on our own. We started paying everything on time. We grabbed some credit, low credit cards. We paid them on time. We grabbed some small loans. We paid them on time just to build a credit. My husband got the car under his name. We pay that every month on time. You can call and dispute things yourself. You can call and be like, hey, I'm going to make a settlement. You're charging me $2,000, but I only have $800. I only have $500. Either you take it or nothing. Trust me, they will take it. They just want money. They don't want this account to be lost. So make sure you work on your credit. Do not You do not have to go out and pay $500, $1,000, $2,000 for someone to fix your credit when you can do it yourself. It's very, very easy. Just take the things you can pay, call them up and be like, hey, I'm going to make a settlement with you. I can pay this amount of month, money monthly, or I can give you a lump sum, whatever it is. Fix your credit yourself. Make sure you take care of your bank accounts. Make sure your bank accounts are always on a positive balance when it comes to ending the day. Buying a new construction comes with its perks. You have some builders cover closing costs. That is $18,000, $20,000 you do not have to come out of pocket with. You just come out of pocket with your down payment, which is a 3.5 or whatever it is in where you are, whatever is fixed where you're at. Find new developers that are going to cover your closing costs. It's just going to save you so much money, and it's gonna alleviate the headache. New constructions, they always have incentives. They always have something. Just if you're thinking of buying a house, honestly, just do it. Go for it. Go look at a new development. Find yourself a good realtor. Put in your application. See where your credit is at. See if you need to work with it. And start working on it. If it would have been for me thinking, oh, my credit's not where it needs to be, I will never get approved, I will still be renting a $2,000 three-bedroom apartment, and my kids will be very uncomfortable. So just go for it, guys. Just throw yourself out there and go for it. Trust me, it was a very tough process, but we got it, we did it, and it was amazing. And I just couldn't share everything. I was not in there. There was moments where I cried to sleep. I cried every day. It was really hard. But we pushed through, and we are in our house. Oh, and when we saw the house, when we put in the application, we came into the empty house. We would come to this house literally every other day. We would come to the house, the girl would give us the key, we would come in, and we were like, oh my god, this is our house, we're gonna do this, we're gonna do that, blah blah blah, blah. We would do all of it, and we would act like this is our home, and we were still like not even close on it. And we would come every weekend, we would come with our family, hey, come see our house. But one thing we did different was we prayed over the house. We anointed the house, we prayed over the house and said, this house belongs to us. This is the gift that God has for us. This is ours. We prayed on it, we sealed it, and that's it. Anyways, guys, but yeah, I just want to encourage you guys today that you can do it. Your dreams can come true. If you have goals, just work really hard and they can come true. This is my story of how I became a homeowner. This is how everything happened. And I hope that this inspired you in going for that dream. It's a good feeling. So guys, stay tuned because I have so many projects for this house that I cannot wait to share with you guys. I'm going to upload an empty house tour so you guys can see my lovely, humble home. So guys, if you like the video and you want to follow along my home journey, everything that I do, please subscribe. And if you like this story time, make sure you give it a thumbs up and let me know in the comments below if you have any other questions when it comes to buying a house or whatever it is that you need to know. Just let me know in the comments down below. I would love to answer your questions and I would love to help you out, whatever it is. So thank you guys for being patient with me. Thank you guys for waiting over a month for me to post the video and for me to actually tell you guys, yes, I purchased a home. We found a house. We got it. I just didn't want to put it out there because I just, you know, haters and whatever. But anyways, guys, if you like the video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And yeah, guys, thank you so much for sticking to the end. Thank you guys for watching my story time. Thank you guys for your love and your support. Always means the world to me. Thank you so much. Muchos besos. I'll see you all on my following video. Adios.